Hey, g'day guys, it's Calvin from the Cartoon Company. I'm kind of sick of guys having discussions on crap that we know is true and real, but we've still got to have this discussion on it. Cam belts, interference engines, and which one you Z engines are interference. I'm about to prove that this engine is an interference engine, okay? I'm gonna look around my workshop, and I do plan to do a much longer video on this particular topic, but I don't have time today. So we're just gonna do a quickie, and I'm gonna prove that this engine here, which is a Gen 2 engine, okay? Don't be fooled by the fuel rails. It's got the light rods in it, it's got the light pistons in it. It's an interference engine. Do I have a Gen 1, a genuine Gen 1 engine here today? That one. This is a proper Gen 1 engine, okay? Big fuel rails, the billet fuel rails, coil facing up. Forget about the airflow meter because I'm doing a mix and match. And this is a Gen 1 engine. Forget about things like this because I mix and match again. But this is actually a 131 Crown engine. Here we have a 1UZ VVTi. Definitely interference. We know that. People don't seem to argue that point. Here we actually have a non-interference engine. And guys go, what? What do you mean? It's got the round fuel rails. Yep, I know. 100% that block there is a heavy rod or a big rod block. We've changed the intake manifold because this engine is getting changed, okay? Non-interference. This one. This is an interference engine. What's a Gen 2 engine with Gen 2 parts. So 100% that is a Gen 2 interference engine. Okay? The 3UZ. I got one of them. 3UZ. Big bit. Interference engine. Okay? Problem comes with this one. This is a Gen 2 engine. This is where the discussions happen. Heavy rods, heavy pistons. Change piston design, increase the compression. Happened in production year, the 9th month of 94. In the LS400s, these changed. Now don't get caught out with SC400s and Soras. They break the rules, okay? You will find later model ones that have got the heavy rods and heavy pistons. That is not unusual. But production year in the LS400s, UCF10 heavy, UCF20 are light rod, light piston, more compression and interference. So am I going to prove it? We're going to get rid of the belt. We're going to turn the engine over. Let's do it. We got it. Are we close enough? I'll bring it in a bit closer, eh? Come here. The better? Right. Oh, I should put it at TDC, eh? There's TDC right there. This is TDC. TDC. And in fact, the time mark. Can you hear me? You probably can't hear me because I've got a thing in my mouth. Time marks at the top are presently lined up. Okay. I didn't want a ratchet power bar for this job. Right. So we're lined up. We need to remove the timing belt. Are we good? That's removed. Now, I was actually having a discussion with some person, or there was a discussion, and the person said they've never seen one of these break an engine when they did a belt. Well, they probably haven't seen enough of these engines. Because when these break a belt, they do touch. Ha! There it is! It don't turn anymore! Because it's touching inside! Do we need any more proof? Interference engine. I cannot do a full revolution. Look at that. Shall I turn it back? And what will be happening when it comes up? Come up, there we go. We're locked up because the pistons are touching the valves, which makes it interference. Okay, simple. So I'm going to summarize. I'm actually pretty annoyed about this because for some reason, some people think that we can just make a decision whether these are interference or not and make up our own mind. We can't. So engineers worked out the physics of this and the engineering principles back in 1994 when they changed the pistons to increase the compression that the valves would now touch. It was all calculated and worked out by the engineers. We don't get to decide. We don't get to make a choice. They touch. They bend. They break. That fly's going to piss me off too. I'm in one of those moods. So guys, UCF20, touch. Interference, you'll bend and break things. In most cases, okay? In most cases. Every now and then, by a stroke of miracle, you might break a belt and you might get away with it. If you do, go buy a lotto ticket because you've been bloody lucky. Because in most cases, and a lot of people I talk to ring me up and want valves, valve guides, at which point you might as well throw the head away. They want these parts, head gaskets, headsets, because they've broken a belt and it's bent the engine. And be careful, as I said, that one over there, that's a Gen 1, but it's got Gen 2 tops on it. That one's a Gen 2, is a Gen 2. That one's a Gen 1 with Gen 1 stuff, but it's going to have Gen 2 management. This one's a Gen 2 engine, and I know it's a Gen 2 engine because when it arrived, that was the coil that was on it, facing forward. This is the tapper cover. See, it's got the small breather. Okay. The back crossover is different on some of the Gen 2s, but not all of them. I got a Gen 1 crossover. That's a Gen 2. That's actually a Gen 1 crossover. So, again, mix and match. And it's got, I don't actually know what manifolds, it's got Gen 2 manifolds on it. It's actually got the proper Gen 2 manifolds. Yes, yes, absolutely. That's the right manifolds as well. Okay, I thought I was done. But I heard someone in the cheap seat say, oh yeah, it's jamming up on something else. It's jamming up on something else. And say, well, the belt's jamming it up. Okay. Fair enough. Fair enough. Understand. What we're going to do... this is a bit noisy. We're going to get rid of this cover. That's how I'm feeling today. This one. Oh, I can't get in there. Got to make an extension. What we're going to do, the plan is, and I have to take this off anyway. It's hard talking and working at the same time. Okay? Now that's better. There's these little hooks just in here. Okay, that's better, eh? We good? We're gonna take these off. Here's the other end of the belt. Here it is there. Should we take this cover off too? We'll take this one off, eh? And I'm going to move the cams away from where it's connecting. And that will prove that it is cams. I actually have never had this bracket off this engine, eh? I've never had the bottom end off. I'll have modified that bottom cover, but I've never actually had this cover off. It is a virgin. Well, it was. It's not a virgin now. Okay, there it goes. It was actually all rusty up in there. And guys, when you're taking this off, normally there's air conditioning bolts. That's the one that guys must. Okay, and what we need to take, I'm not gonna take the alternator off, but I'm gonna take this off. Yes, I am doing the shifters with a rattle gun. And it really surprises me that we're having a discussion that these are non-interference. You know, 94 was a long time ago. And I thought we would have well established it, but thanks to the internet, this misinformation continues. And a big part of what I'm about is getting rid of that misinformation. Right, have we got it? Are we close enough? So I'll bring it round. Remember, the yellow mark gets to about here before it actually touches. And if you are worried about this engine, I've got to take the heads off it. It's got leaking valves on number 7. I'm not doing it this time. Okay, we come to there. Okay, so that point it goes firm. The belt is actually floppy. Coil piece, all right. So theoretically, I should be able to turn these camshafts away and allow this to turn more. It's not touching on this side. Tonk! Are we seeing this? Now I'm really stuffed up my timing, eh? It's going to be much more of a challenge to get back, and I might have to do a video on how to sort Calvin's stuff ups. Now we should come around to where it touches again and jams up. I just pull this out. That was jamming up on the belt. Okay, so what's happened here, which is really interesting too, is I've actually made it when I've moved the camshafts on this side. Now it's not actually touching. I've just done a full revolution. I think I've just done 2 full revolutions and no touchy-touchy of valves. I'm going to bring it back again to TDC. Back to TDC, we're good. I'm going to pull this one back to its timing mark very carefully. I'm actually going to change my bars because this is a ratchet and it's got the potential to swing and actually bam those valves into those pistons. I've got the small bar, but it's a not a back and forth bar, not a ratchet bar. Oh, there it goes. Where is that mark? Can't turn it again. Here is that. Okay, so that's back in the correct spot, okay? But you did see, if I go around too far, touching again. But watch, if I take it around to here, if I take my piston down, we got that? Because that valve is touching that piston. I think that's pretty conclusive, guys. And I showed two things. One is if the engine stops in just the right spot, then you should be buying that lotto ticket, okay? Because you're bloody lucky. But most of the time, you're not. It's going to clash those pistons into those valves, and it's going to wreck shit, okay? So change your timing belt. Okay, guys. So I hope that's been helpful. And I hope it clears up that Gen 1 are non-interference. Gen 2, can't have that single. And Gen 2 onwards are interference. Okay, VVTIs are interference. It does raise the question of those pistons, I know, and the rods and what's going on in there, but that's for another video for another day. Okay, I do happen to have rods and pistons sitting there to show the difference. And we still have guys asking, how do I tell which engine? I've got videos on that as well, but I might just do another one at some point as well. Hope that's been helpful. We'll talk to you again soon. Catch you later. Hey boys. Yeah, I know, Mr. Grumpy. Come on boys, come on. Come on. Oi, come with me. Come on. Oi, come on guys. Come on. Come on. Come on. There you go. Come on. Good boys. No, no, keep moving. Can you look? Well, there's grass. Working out yet? Watch it, you. Go on. Are you coming, buddy? Not those sheep, tell them to Mr. Bull.